3D in space. Why do we even care? It's really hard to build a satellite. It's really expensive. What's the point? Well, okay, so I alluded to these points, but I don't think I said it. The secure distance for QED is limited by the loss of photons. So we always lose photons in the atmosphere or through fiber or whatever. Most of our photons get lost. And the farther you go, the more get lost, obviously. And the problem is that the detector dark counts start to cover the signal. So the detectors that I showed always click, not always, they sometimes click even when there's no photons present. And since this just happens randomly, that's a 50% error rate. So that's way too much for QED. You can't tolerate that. So as soon as the number of arriving photons is like less than the number of dark counts, then the error rate shoots up, QKD is no longer possible. So this is like the graph that every QKD paper must have. It's a Q rate versus distance, so that it drops nicely linearly, and eventually there's some sharp cutoff. And so QKD rate goes to zero, or zero on this graph is like negative infinity, so it goes to zero. And beyond this distance, it's just impossible. So this is basically a property of every QKD system so far. The limits are about 250 kilometers in optical fiber and 144 kilometers through free space. So obviously we can't amplify the signal. I think you've proved the no cloning theorem or seen it. Yeah, great. So great, it's a quantum signal. You can't just simply reamplify it in a simple repeater station. There's something called quantum repeaters, and those are pretty nice, but difficult to do. So these are based like this. So instead of just Alice and Bob, we're going to talk about entanglement. So BBM 92 protocol, the entangled protocol. And so you just share an entangled pair of photons over a really long distance. And instead of just having one source in the middle, we have a bunch of so-called quantum repeater nodes. So we have lots of entangled photon sources, and then repeaters all through here. So what happens is this source would distribute an entangled pair here, and then this has to store that entangled photon until this source also distributes an entangled pair here. And then so these two photons come together and they can do something called entanglement swapping. So now the entanglement starts between here and here, but then it's swapped along, along, along. So eventually Alice and Bob can share entanglement and there's no entanglement in the middle anymore. But this requires to store photons. And if you've ever tried to hold a photon, it's really hard. So we only have, I think our storage can be a few microseconds now, which isn't great, but it has to be like seconds long for this storage to work. So quantum repeaters, they would be awesome, but they're a future technology. It looks like we can do space now. So a few satellites somewhere around the world orbiting could probably cover the Earth, it looks like. So we can do QKD here and here and between them and down, and yeah, that's probably sufficient. Just as the simplest example is one satellite, and it's orbiting around the Earth, but now we trust it. So we use it as a trusted node. And this works like this. So Alice sends up her key to the satellite, call it KA. The satellite keeps moving. Eventually, it'll pass over Bob, somewhere on the other side of the world. And so Bob sends up a totally different key, KB. So this is QKD here. This is a different QKD here. But now the satellite knows two keys, one from Alice, one from Bob. So what the satellite can do is just combine these keys. So this is just bitwise addition. 0 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 plus 0 is 1. Pretty simple. And it sends this combined key back down to Bob, just classically. So now Bob knows the combined key. Bob knows his key. And by another simple bitwise addition, he extracts Alice's key. So we use the satellite as this intermediate trusted node. And now Alice and Bob both know Alice's key. But the satellite also knows it, which is why we have to trust it. So this is essentially what we're working towards. As the first demonstration, would be one satellite flying around the Earth doing QKD. We can also remove the need for trusted nodes with entanglement. So you can imagine one transmitter, one satellite, sending entangled photons to two receivers. They can just do BBM 90 protocol directly. So you can think of some entanglement instead. And there's lots of different scenarios. These just get more and more complicated and more hard to do. But there's lots of ideas on how to do QKD with satellites. But some of the challenges. So that nice picture was great. There's these satellites doing the whole Earth, and it's not so bad. But here's a to-scale picture. So our low Earth orbit satellites are these tiny dots just here. So they're really close to Earth, and they're moving really fast. That means they don't have very long to do QKD. And they definitely can't see each other. If they're only like 500 kilometers up, the Earth is totally in the way. And they can't see very far on the ground either. The other thing would be to use a geostationary satellite. So that doesn't move with respect to the Earth, so there's a lot of time. But it's like really far away. It's somewhere over here, I think. And so that just means the loss between the satellite and the Earth is huge. And that makes QKD hard as well. So we calculated for this geostationary satellite, it's 36,000 kilometers away. It would take about 10 days just to get your first secure key bit across. That's pretty slow. OK, so another challenge of space is the loss. So even if the satellite's only 500 kilometers above Earth, we saw that the farthest distance so far was like 200 kilometers. So this is still kind of hard to do. But it's not as bad because there's no atmosphere. So maybe there's some hope. So just the various, there's a bunch of different things that cause loss. The absorption is, yeah, it's not so bad. There's no atmosphere in space. The detector efficiency, yeah, I told you we're getting those like really efficient detectors and not so bad. The pointing error, so just like trying to aim the satellite at your ground station, that can be hard. But it seems like we can improve that just with lots of money. Beam spreading, that's like a fundamental physical problem. So the beam will necessarily spread out, even if it's in free space. And atmosphere turbulence, if you're going up, that's really bad. So the beam hits the atmosphere, gets all distorted by the turbulence, and then really expands as it goes into space. So it's totally hard to collect this massive beam with a small satellite. And so just to show you what the problem's like. So here is the satellite height in kilometers. The low Earth orbit somewhere down here, like a few hundred. The geostationary somewhere up here. And this is the total loss we expect. And since this is a log scale, so this means 0 dB means no loss at all. 10 dB means you get 10% of your photons across. 20 dB means you only get 1%. 30 dB means you get 0.1%, and so on and so forth. And so we're somewhere down here. QKD has been demonstrated up here, but satellites are down here. So this is kind of tough. You can see there's a tiny bit of overlap in this little corner right here for a downlink and for a LEO satellite. But for a GEO satellite, there's a massive gap, orders of magnitude gap in permissible loss. So there's lots of work still to be done before QKD satellites is a reality. So it seems like every paper is an important step. Everything says step, you know. It's a step towards satellite. It's a crucial step. But there's no mission yet. So just as an example of how unsure we are. So the estimates of an uplink loss, the photon loss from ground to a satellite, they range from 20 to 60 decibels. And since this is a decibel scale, that means it's orders of magnitude. And so it's like estimating the height of the CN Tower. It's somewhere between a meter and 10 kilometers. That's a pretty poor estimate. And so this is a pretty tricky estimate of uplink loss. So essentially, we don't really know what's going to happen, but we're definitely working towards it. IQC is working on a mission with the Canadian Space Agency. So we hope to have a satellite flying soon enough. And so to finish off, I guess, I'll just show you, this is like the typical picture of QKD to a satellite. And so I'd like you to point out everything that's wrong with it. OK. So it looks like QKD is almost ready for space. We might be able to do a launch in 3 years or so. There's lots of activity worldwide in this, like China and the European Union and Japan all have racing to build a satellite. The secure global network, however, that's more far off. So this first demonstration might be soon enough, but the full network is a little trickier. And we really need lots of expertise in quantum mechanics, quantum computing, optics, and like space engineering. So this is a great challenge, and I hope we see a QKD satellite soon. So yeah, that's it for me. Thanks for your attention.